Today, the Wise Guy is starting off with a project briefing and will show you how to install drywall, tape, mud, and wall texture in the backyard shed project in the Wise Guy fashion. Please remember to hit the like button and subscribe. Let's get started.
Next morning, early, drinking a cup of Joe, about ready to get outside. Today we're gonna run some drywall, complete, basically turning that thing into like a ice chest, an igloo, and checking out the weather forecast.
Time for the first piece of drywall. We need to put it up on the ceiling. What we got in place right now is the helper we're showing you. Makes a slot for the half inch sheetrock to slide in. Then we hold the other end up with just an ordinary 2x4. Let's get this piece of sheetrock on the ceiling. Once we get it held up onto the ceiling, we'll use 1¼ inch screws and fasten it to the ceiling rafters. All right, through this helper in place, we got the other one holding it up. Let's put some screws in this drywall.
Folks, you just witnessed the Wise Guy work fashion. The placement of a 4-foot by 8-foot sheet of drywall weighing roughly 50 pounds and videoing it being suspended to the ceiling with only 1 2x4 support and an additional board screwed to the wall.
This is what it looks like screwed off. I got 3 more 4x8s to get up on this ceiling. Let's get sheet rocking.
The Wise Guy got into a hanging drywall zone and unfortunately missed filming the installation of the interior walls. Let's get back to watching him pump it out in the Wise Guy fashion.
All right, just finished the sheet rocking on the shed. Interior came out nice. Just finished running all the screws. Check out the radius corners. The miters came out nice. Now we're about ready to tape it off. All the corners. Even the window, every seam, let's get to work. All right, can't get any easier. Pre-stick tape. So easy. Then we'll come back. Hit it with 1 coat of mud. Use a 2nd coat to pream it out before sanding the mud. Let's get this inside corner. Coming in crooked. All right. We'll go down the ladder. Just keep it going. Like so. Might as well just keep on going. And finish it up at the bottom.
work this corner. Try to straighten that out a little bit. Easy breezy.
Okay. It's obvious the wise guy is in a total kick butt, get the job done fashion. He applied the mud and unfortunately again missed filming it. The wise guy apologized to all who wanted to see the drywall mud installation. Let's get back to the wise guy in action.
All right, we've been laying down the mud. It's kind of humid in here now. We gotta do a little touch up to it. But this is basically it. Okay, we have to do from here and finish all through there. Let's get laying on some mud. Got a crack and a 5. Another 5 gallon. We didn't use, this was what was left of another 5 I had from previous job. All right, let's get that new 5 and be spreading that brand new mud. All right, we ain't got a brand new 5 from the garage. The backyard headquarters. All right. Should be one more bucket. That should do it. Let's get spreading. Well, this mud here is kind of tan, orangey. First bit of mud was from a project we did about a month ago. Got that terracotta color mud. All right, mud is mud. Makes no difference color it is. After these last couple of coats, gotta do the window. Kinda let it stiffen up. What we laid up, what we spread it, right? Call it the first coat. Let it stiffen up for about, I don't know, hour. Go take some lunch. Come back, and we'll hit it with the touch-up coat. Get it all nice and pretty looking.
Ready for the sanding action. Building this up so this way we don't have too much of caulk on that side or the door casing when it rolls over a little bit when we nail it, it won't be that noticeable. Yeah, that first coat, you just see me lay up. Yeah, it didn't look all that great, but the second one, everything will smooth out. Second one goes real fast. It's more like a touch-up. I just had to get some mud down on there, build that up a little bit. Kind of the same thing with this window. Just finished putting on the second coat. We really knocked it out today. Take a look at the window. Came out nice. Just like the door. It's pretty wet up there. Pretty humid in here. If it dries up by tomorrow morning, we'll sand it up and we'll apply the texture. That's how we do it at the backyard project. These are the tools and supplies I used to create the texture. I just used a general purpose, basically a joining compound, and basically thinned it with water. Mixed it up with this paddle on a half inch drill. Then we basically got our compressor, right? Plugged it into our spray hopper. Kind of like in Scarface, say hello to my little friend.
Hello to my little friend.
First, let me say sorry. I couldn't include you in making the video of me actually doing it. Man, came out nice. What we're talking about is the texture. Yeah, the detail on the basic window looks really nice. Look at the corners. I guarantee it, when you put out corners like this, those buyers and customers are not complaining.
Thank you for watching our Wise Guy video. Join us on the upcoming video, Shed Interior Painting. Please remember to hit the like button and subscribe. Like always, we'll see you on the next video.